So we've been talking about the trusted computing base, what it has to do, the fact that it has to be small, but it has to be sort of the kernel or be at the center of everything, isn't it? We talked about, you know, it should do complete mediation. You have to go through it to get to physical hardware resources, or we shouldn't be able to bypass it. So that means, you know, this is something you always go through, and this is at the heart or core of any system that we have. So the kernel is that core, the innermost, the most trusted, hopefully something that you can trust for things to be right. And this kernel is where the security mechanisms have to be enforced. So the security kernel is sort of at the center of the core. It has to enforce anything to do with security. The fact that although it's at the center, it's small, it's just the kernel, and it's not everything, that entire blob, hopefully that helps with good isolation. Small size is good for verifiability. So kernel design basically says, you know, look for the smallest possible system where you can put your security mechanisms. The reference monitor that controls access to objects, where all references are monitored. Enforcement of all security mechanisms, access to protected objects or resources is one of those. So the reference monitor function, of course, has to be one that the security kernel has to address. And the security kernel, since good isolation, actually it becomes the core of the trusted computing base or the trusted computing base. So it has to be tamper-proof. You shouldn't be able to bypass it. Always gets in the way. It's always invoked. That's our complete mediation function or reference monitor that has to check every reference. And going back to the small size we had before, we want the small size is going to help us be able to analyze it and understand it and make sure that it does enforce or implement the security mechanisms that we need and those implementations are correct. So the idea here is that trusted computing base, one approach is the security kernel approach, where you bring the security relevant functions together, and that goes at the core of the system that you're trying to build.